Hi there, it's Tyler from Nelly Security. Welcome back to our series, How to Build an IP Surveillance System. In our last video, we talked about surveillance brands. With the right brand in mind, we've really narrowed down the products that we need for our system quite a bit, but there are still several questions that we need to ask in order to get this system specifically tailored to you and your situation. Once we answer these questions, we'll pretty much have all of your products picked out and ready to go. So let's go ahead and jump right in. Question number one is, how many security cameras do you need? The answer to this question is totally going to depend on the amount of surveillance coverage that you need and the number of areas that you'd like to keep an eye on. Common areas for your home security system include your front door, your back door, your front porch, your driveway, your garage, your street, your front yard, your backyard, all four sides of your house, any living spaces, bedrooms, any areas where you keep safes. Common surveillance areas for business security systems include any entrances and exits, parking lots, lobbies and other customer areas, employee-only areas, cash registers, seating areas, restaurant kitchens. These lists could go on and on. So go ahead and take a few moments to determine what areas are most important for your surveillance system. Are there multiple areas that you could cover with only one camera? Maybe with a wide-angle lens or a fisheye lens or a PTZ? Go ahead and pause this video and write down every area that you need to secure with a camera. All right, do you have your list? Good. You now know how many security cameras you need. You now also know what size recorder you need. If you have up to four cameras, you're going to need at least a four-channel recorder. If you have up to eight cameras, an eight-channel recorder. Up to 16 cameras, a 16-channel recorder. You get the idea. But be careful not to limit yourself here. If you've determined that you need exactly four security cameras, I would encourage you to consider an 8-channel recorder instead of a 4-channel, just so that you can expand your system later down the road. Now that we have the number of cameras that we need in our system, it's time to determine which cameras we want. You will most likely want the same camera pretty much everywhere, although certain situations may call for a different type of camera, and we will get to those special circumstances here in a bit. First, let's decide on a default camera that will make up the bulk of our system. Here are a couple of questions to that end. Do you have a preferred form factor? Security cameras come in a ton of different types, from standard bullets, to vandal-proof domes, to turrets, to giant PTZs, and security camera lenses come in all different shapes and sizes, depending on whether it's fixed at a given length or zoomable. To determine the form factor of our camera, we need to decide on a housing and on a lens type. Let's talk housings. Bullet cameras are fantastic. They have powerful function and excellent image quality day and night. The problem is they usually are a bit bulky and they're pretty easy to manipulate. Someone can easily walk up and turn the lens or knock your camera down. So if you decide on a bullet camera, just be sure to install this in a pretty high location so that it is out of reach. Vandal domes do fix this problem with this glass vandal resistant dome. These things are pretty tough and durable, and someone's not going to be able to come along and turn the lens around or smash your camera. These cameras are ideal in situations where vandalism is a concern, or just in a place where you need to install a security camera within arm's reach. The drawback is that sometimes this glass dome can cause reflection, especially at night. If you're not careful, the infrared lights can bounce back off of this dome, causing a slightly blurry or washed out image. Turret cameras really are the best of both worlds when it comes to form factor. It's as tough and durable as a vandal dome, but it has the excellent image quality of a bullet camera. If you don't have a particular housing in mind, we do recommend going with turrets. Just grab a few of these and you'll be set. For lens types, we do recommend fixed lens cameras for most situations. These lenses are usually pretty wide, so you will be able to see pretty much everything that is happening in a wide space. And if you get a high resolution camera like 4 megapixel or 5 megapixel, or even 8 megapixel Ultra HD, you will be able to digitally zoom in on your image and maintain most of that detail. However, if you know that you will need to be zooming in your camera quite a bit, going back and forth from a wide field of view to a cropped, zoomed in field of view, you may want to consider our motorized lens cameras. With these cameras, you can optically zoom in and maintain every pixel of your image. Our next question is, do you have a resolution preference? Security cameras also come in many different resolutions, from 2 megapixel or full HD 1080p, all the way up to 8 megapixel or 4K, or even 12 megapixel. There are a ton of choices available to you. The resolution that you pick is going to depend on a few factors like your budget, your preferred viewing method, and how much detail you're going to need to see in your image. The first factor is your budget. The higher resolution you choose, the higher price your camera is going to be. So if price is more important to you than image quality, you can get a bigger bang for your buck by going with a lower resolution. Next is your preferred viewing method. If you're pretty much only going to be viewing your cameras from your cell phone, then you probably don't need a 4K Ultra HD image. On the other hand, if you're going to have a huge 4K TV monitor connected to your NVR, then you probably will benefit from a much larger and higher resolution image. Finally, how much detail do you need? You might not necessarily need a whole lot of detail if you're just trying to record what's happening in your front yard. You can probably get by with a lower resolution. However, if you have a wide-angle lens and you do want to take advantage of digital zoom, and it's important that you maintain as much detail as possible, then you will need a higher resolution so that you do have more pixels to zoom in on. If you still don't know what resolution you need, we recommend going with either 4 megapixel or 5 megapixel, depending on the surveillance brand that you chose in the last video. These cameras will give you a much higher quality image than 1080p, but they're not nearly as pricey as 4K cameras. All right, you should now have all the info that you need to fill out the bulk of your security system, and for most people, this is going to be sufficient. However, we do have a variety of other cameras that you may want to consider if you're looking for a very specific solution to a specific problem. I briefly mentioned these cameras in the last video when talking about the H series brand of surveillance products. All of these cameras do fall into that brand. So if you are planning on investing in an H series system, then you may be interested in adding one of these cameras. Our doorbell camera is a great addition to any home security system. With this, you can keep an eye on your front porch, receive motion detection notifications from your cell phone, and talk to visitors using two-way audio. We also have our night color camera for seeing your surveillance footage in color 24/7. Its integrated floodlight also makes this a great option for a driveway camera. We have an active deterrence camera with an integrated strobe light and siren for warning intruders that they're being recorded. We also have our indoor Wi-Fi cube camera, which you can place pretty much anywhere in your house for high definition 5 megapixel video and two-way audio. Our license plate recognition camera is especially useful in parking lots or alleyways where you want to keep track of the cars that come and go. And if you have a business or a storefront, you may want our HDMI cameras, which easily connect to an external monitor for public viewing, similar to the monitors you'll see inside Walmart or Target. I would encourage you to go ahead and visit NellySecurity.com so that you can browse all of our products, read the product descriptions, check out the spec sheets, watch any related videos, read any related blog posts. We have a ton of resources over there for you to really make sure that you are getting the best cameras for you and for your security system. Now onto the final question, which relates to your recorder. Your network video recorder, or NVR, is the central component of your surveillance system. From here, you can manage all of your cameras in one place, and most importantly, this is where you will save all of your surveillance footage. So for this, we have to ask the question, how many days of surveillance footage do you want to keep? This is going to determine the size of the hard drive that we place into your NVR. If you're not quite sure how many days you want, here is a general rule. For residential applications, you can probably get by with about 7 days worth of recordings. But if this is for a business, you might want to stick with an entire month's worth of surveillance footage. Now, there are a few ways to optimize your recording space. For instance, you don't have to record all the time. You can set up recording triggers based on smart events or motion detection. You can also set up daily and weekly schedules to make sure that you're only recording when you want to be recording. If you would like a full, in-depth explanation of NVR hard drive storage, we do have another video, which I will link in the description. Check that out and it will give you probably more info than you need. I will also link a calculator tool down in the description, which you can use to input the number of cameras you have, and it will tell you how much hard drive space you need. And congratulations, you now know everything you need to know in order to piece together your surveillance system from scratch. You know exactly how many cameras you need, you know exactly which cameras you need, you know which NVR you need and how much hard drive space to put in that NVR. In the next video, we're going to talk about installation. We will go over cable types and tool types, as well as any related mounts or junction boxes that you might need. In the meantime, if you have any unanswered questions about what products you need or how to build your own IP surveillance system, please don't hesitate to give us a call or send us an email. Our experts are standing by, waiting to help you put together the perfect system, customized uniquely for you and your home or business. Don't forget to like and share this video if you found it helpful, and be sure to follow us across social media so you never miss another video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time.